Morning readers, hi, this is day 3 and what we are going to do today is slightly different. We are kind of heading inland to see if we can find some authentic Goan breakfast, and from there on we're planning to go to a place called as Kolwa Beach. Now, yeah, I mean, when you're in Goa, other than beaches, you don't find anything else. So we were at Palalam Beach. Now we're going to go to Kolwa Beach and a couple of places from there on, which also happens to be beaches. So yeah, that's the plan. We're going to kind of take our day very slowly today because we're going to be heading back tomorrow. So don't want to kind of overexert or do long rides or probably, you know, the day rides today too much, because then you don't have the energy left in the day for yourself, as well as, you know, you're not relaxed tomorrow morning. So yeah, slowly and easily we're gonna pass the day 3.
Beach, and it's good, but not much to do here. Predominantly, I think it's only a beach out here, and a few water sport activities do happen. So yeah, just probably will spend some time here and then probably head to another beach. There's another beach called Varka, if I'm not wrong, if I've not mispronounced it. That's the beach that we might go across to. We'll see, take a few pictures and then go ahead. Come to Fisherman's Bar and Restaurant, and we've ordered across for a Goan fish thali. Let's see how it tastes and what varieties do I get. And my wife has ordered, as usual, the dal fry and tandoori roti. She's a veg, by the way, so she doesn't have non-veg. So yeah, it's only me who's gonna enjoy this time. So yeah, I'll walk you through as to what I get in the plate. And the Palalam market right now, and trying to see if we can buy something for some of my family members. Picking up some t-shirts and stuff like that. Let's see.
Good morning, readers. So, time is exactly 6:29, and I have started the return journey. So, Google shows me around 8 hours of time. Now I need to kind of see how quickly I can reach, because most of it, I think good 200 kilometers is through the state highway, and yeah, it's hard to cruise through that because, you know, there is no street lights, there's no, you know, sort of access control road, right? In a sense, anyone can enter from any side of the road, so you need to be careful of probably the animals or the cattle that kind of, you know, cross the road at the night, so you need to be careful of those. Plus, you know, there are some sharp turns around that place, so it becomes a little risky at that time. Okay, so we've turned on to the national highway now, and then we're gonna be heading down towards 300 kilometers more to reach Bangalore. From here on, it's, you know, in the direction of your nose. I mean, straight line is straight line, right? So we're just gonna be continuing there, and yeah, I mean, hopefully by one or two o'clock we should be nearing Bangalore. So till then, yeah, let's just stay on the highway.